Inside another problem. Permit me to offer you a piece of truth, Sergeant. My training and sophistication in the field of social research gives me much more insight than any policeman could ever have. Professor, let me ask you something. What's that? What did you do after graduating from high school? I attended the university and obtained my degree. Then what? I continued my studies, completed the master's program, and went on for my PhD. What kind of work did you do while you were going through school? My, we have a regular interrogation going on here, haven't we? Up until I took my master's, I devoted all my time to studying research, and then became a teaching assistant in the sociology department. And after you obtained your PhD, I remained as an associate until I gained full professorship. I ask you, Sergeant, what is your point?
The point is, Professor, that you've spent your entire life in an academic environment surrounded with research, studies, and intellectual discussions on the ills of society. Walk outside the classroom and take a look at what really goes on before you publish your next study, will you? Take a look at the world of an addict like John Aldrich before you rule on antique laws and archaic methods. Give it that much, Professor.
For your edification, Sergeant, I've seen a lot more than you may think I have. It's not all as dreary as you make it out to be with your rash generalizations.
Oh, I've seen it too, Professor. So often my stomach turns every time I think of it. All the things you can't put in a test tube or analyze in a computer. Rich kids, middle class kids, and poor kids, all attaching themselves to something they can't find any other way except by blowing grass or dropping a pill or mainlining heroin. Now they get a chance to grow up, maybe. But what do they become? Vegetables, welfare cases, husbands, wives, mothers, fathers that don't have the maturity or emotional balance to handle their own lives, much less influence others. They live in their own little world of rosy red paths and cloudy dreams. And when the dreams are over, what's left? They're safe from their sight, all they're broken and they're dead. Yeah, they build a nice future for themselves, don't they? A future built on a foundation of weed, needles, and psychedelic logic. That's a rich future, Professor, isn't it? We've given these young minds a lot to build on, haven't we? The intellectuals justify it and the hoodlums reap the harvest. Think about it, Professor Thurston.
Yeah,
say, dig a little